So, today we're going to be looking at Routine, which is a daily planner application for you to manage your calendar and tasks in one location. Today, I'll be giving you an insightful review of Routine to see whether it's right for you at home and to see whether it's the best daily planner application on the market. So before we begin, jump over to toolfinder.co because you'll find all of the best alternatives and insight into Routine there, including scorecards, reviews, and more. If you want to find a Routine and any deals and offers we have on it, you can find it linked below. So Routine is super interesting. It's an application that combines three systems, agenda or the calendar, tasks and notes, which is trying to be a productivity system. But what is the pricing before we begin? Now, Routine is free to use. You can connect it up with Google Calendar, Outlook and other services to better enhance how you're managing your calendar. It's also got a professional pricing that is set to be released yet and a business pricing. But right now there is a Believer plan, which is $10 per user per month. Now this gives you advanced features and additional calendar layouts and more, and it's very much in its early days. So this application has an agenda view, and as you can see, I can move stuff about for future and I can move it to the past if I do want to. Now I can click into this task and I can add any notes here. I can also postpone it, reschedule it, if I do want to, for example, to tomorrow. Now, I can obviously see that I have cancelled my block time, so it just makes sure that I'm going ahead with that all okay. And if I go back, I've got nothing on my list. But I can add any task here. And it doesn't have to be timed blocked. You can see any tasks here that are not time blocked and drag them into the system if you want to. There's also a calendar view, which you can also use to time block and make bigger, as well as tag them into the relevant project too. So for example, if I wanted to tick this item off, as I said, of clean the guttering, and if I wanted to, I could see any day associated tasks, so like that task ABC one and that clean garden one that I had before, as well as in a week and a month view. Now this is quite nice. If I want to use this as a place to write notes to myself, I can even share that with collaborative abilities, and I can postpone this as well. Now you may notice I've also got a Wirecutter article that I saved. Now this is important because you can actually bring items in using their console feature, which is basically a way to capture them into an inbox, which you can organize for later, which is a great way to better manage your system. So there's a tasks area that's dedicated. This helps you to see any upcoming stuff that you're working on, and it allows you to add any subtasks that are part of this, which are naturally part of the different areas that you've got. But you can also organize them into notes, which is essentially a notes area for the different folders and notes lists that you've got. So for example, if you want to start writing a list of things that you want to do or goals that you want to achieve, then you can do that here. And you can also see the meetings that you've created and ones that have taken based on your Google Calendar. So if you look at it as a whole, that's really the main core elements of Routine. Now, there are additional abilities which you can access in settings. For example, adding additional accounts can be done from here, and you can also add additional calendars. Now, there are also preferences and integrations. The integrations is quite nice because you have the ability to connect with Notion, which means you can synchronize tasks with a workspace in Notion. There's also a journal feature here for seeing all the things you completed as well. And that's pretty much it when it comes to the other additional integrations. Now, I want to show you the console feature, which is accessible through the settings. You can compress Command J. Well, you can set it up basically in the shortcuts area. But this comes up when you take a image, and it's perfect because you can add a task, capture an event, or just add some more details and see future stuff. It's a great way to focus in on what you're working on. There is a search area. So for example, if I wanted to find the Planet of the Apes movie, then I could write stuff here. Now adding additional stuff to here is quite helpful. For example, you can also use additional views. This is almost like an unpublished feature, so I won't really talk about that yet, but they do want to add more project management and collaborative abilities for teams as well. But this is really the sort of bread and butter, the task, calendar, and notes experience as well. Capturing notes is really easy using that console feature, and being able to organize them as well is another great thing too. So you can start to really quickly organize them and see the people and pages and things like that. So there is additional abilities. When you connect it with a Google Workspace, you can have a directory, which means you can see certain people as well. So all in all, the pros and cons of Routine. I love the minimalist nature and design of the application. I love the console feature as well. Probably one of the killer abilities for capturing notes, agenda, events, and items. However, I wasn't fully impressed with the experience when it comes to other abilities like explaining certain things. For example, this area, the calendar area, very messy to actually use practically during the day. There's tasks coming here, there's tasks over here. It sort of feels a little bit disjointed as a calendar experience. The task area is nice, but it could be improved with some additional views. And largely, the ability to capture is probably the saving grace to bringing items into your system. So if you want to check out Routine and explore more reviews from us, then you can find it linked below if you're interested. If you want to explore more alternatives to Routine, then you can jump over to toolfinder.co to explore more. So our recommendation is this is good for busy professionals looking for a simple productivity system and eager to wait for this application to evolve into much more because they have bolder and brighter plans.